देवेश सिंह, आई एम एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन अजय कुमार गर्ग इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज। आई विल कवर वेरियस टॉपिक्स ऑफ इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट। सो एज ए फर्स्ट टॉपिक आई विल कवर IC741। सो इफ वी सी द सीमेटिक ऑफ IC741, इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ 23 BJTs, वन कैपेसिटर एंड फ्यू रजिस्टर्स। So it consists of different stages. So as we know, in all the integrated circuits, definitely there will be one bias circuit. So we will have bias circuit highlighted in red, and the corresponding blocks in this circuit are encircled, are covered in red zones. So all these circuits which are covered in red zone, they are providing bias to the circuit. Then definitely there will be an input stage. So this input stage is for providing the external input signal. So here we can see this is transistor pair Q1 and Q2. This is used for providing the input. So we have shown this input stage in green color. So this complete section shows the input stage of 741. Then third stage is gain stage, which is also called second stage or intermediate stage. So it provides the bulk of gain realized by the 741 op amp. And then we have to deliver the output in efficient manner. So we will have to use some output stage. So this transistor Q14 and Q20, this is a class AB output stage which will deliver the power. So here we have total, coming to the bias circuit, these are the four biasing sections. So here first we generate the reference current. So this reference current is generated by transistor Q12 11 and using this resistor R5. So this reference current is replicated by this lower mirror, which is called Wedler current source. So we will get some collector current which will be proportional to the reference current. Then we have another current mirror formed by transistor Q12 and Q13. Transistor Q13 is double collector transistor. Double collector transistor, we can understand this double collector transistor as two transistor whose base emitter junctions are in parallel, or they are connected in parallel. Then we have another current mirror formed by transistor Q8 and Q9. So this is providing bias to the input stage. This is the input stage. While this transistor Q13A is providing biasing to the output transistor Q14 and Q20, which is forming the output stage, class AB output stage. We have another section of two transistors, that is Q18 and Q19. So this particular set of transistor provide twice of VBE drop between the bases of transistor Q14 and Q20, which is necessary for providing distortion less output. Now coming to these sections one by one. So here first reference current is provided by transistor Q12 and Q11 using this resistor R5, which is having value of 39 kilo ohms. Then second bias is provided by the Wedler current mirror formed by transistor Q11 and Q10. And it consists of resistor R5. So by varying the resistor R5, we can manipulate or vary the collector current of transistor Q10. And this collector current will provide biasing to the input stage, as we can see in this diagram. So here, this is providing the biasing to the इनपुट स्टेज फॉर ट्रांजिस्टर Q3 एंड Q4. सो बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेजेंस ऑफ दिस रजिस्टर दिस इज ए स्पेसिफिक करेंट मिरर विच इज गिवन नेम विडलर करेंट सोर्स. इन कन्वेंशनल करेंट मिरर्स देयर इज नो रजिस्टेंस. सो इन दैट केस इफ बोथ द ट्रांजिस्टर लेट से Q10 एंड Q11 बोथ आर मैच्ड देन इन दैट केस द कलेक्टर करेंट ऑफ दिस ट्रांजिस्टर दैट इज Q11 एंड Q10 बोथ विल बी इक्वल. So right now this will not be the case in Widler current source. Reason: a drop based to emitter voltage of transistor Q11 is divided in two parts, which is nothing but base emitter voltage of transistor Q10 and voltage drop across resistance R4. So definitely the collector current of this transistor will not be equal to the collector current of transistor Q11, even if the transistors are matched. Now, this is the another current mirror, which is simple current mirror formed by Q8 and Q9. So, as we have already seen, this Q8 and Q9 current mirror is biasing the input stage of transistor. Now, transistor Q12 and Q13, which is forming another simple current mirror. So, Q13A is biasing the output stage, while Q13B is biasing the gain stage, as we can see in this diagram. Q13A is biasing this gain stage transistor Q17. So, this complete stage is gain stage. And now coming to the output stage, which is biased by transistor Q18 and Q19. So, role of this transistor is to provide twice of VBE drop between the bases of these two transistors, Q14 and Q20. Now, we will see the short circuit production. We have some additional circuitry in IC741, which is used for short circuit protection. So, normally this circuit remains off and this will be active when a large current will flow through the op-amp. So, large current will flow, for example, if by fault we connect the output to one of the power supply. In that case, there will be no effective load and because of short circuiting, we will have large current flow. So, just to avoid this, just to protect the IC741, we will use this particular transistor pair, that is Q22, Q24, these two resistors and transistor Q19 and 21. So, this circuitry will be active to protect the circuit 741 under large current flow condition. Now coming to the input stage, which is also known as differential stage or first stage. So here we are providing the input using through the base of transistor Q1 and Q2. So if we see transistor Q1 and Q2, they are working as an emitter follower, that is common collector configuration. So why we need it? This common collector configuration will provide very high input impedance. So, this high input impedance will be providing the input without any loading. And this transistor Q3 and Q5, this transistor Q3 and Q5, which is working in common base mode, this will process the signal of Q1 and Q2 transistors. So, if we see this common collector and common base transistors, we can consider either this set or this set, both have same functioning. So, this will provide very high input impedance and this cascade connection is also गुड इन टर्म्स ऑफ इट्स हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी रिस्पॉन्स. दिस पर्टिकुलर सेक्शन इज अनदर करेंट मिरर. सो हेयर वी हैव नॉट यूज्ड अ डायोड कनेक्टेड ट्रांजिस्टर दैट इज Q5, रादर इट इज कनेक्टेड थ्रू ए ट्रांजिस्टर Q7. So this signal provided by this differential input, let's say this is the positive terminal of op-amp, this is the negative terminal of op-amp, the output will be provided single-endedly to the gain stage. This is the gain stage. So load part is actually consist of this section, transistor Q5, Q6 and Q7 along with these three resistors R1, R2 and R3. So role of current mirror, it will provide high output impedance to the input signal and this will convert the differential signal applied at the basis of Q1 and Q2 in single ended way to the gain stage without any loss of signal. So without any loss of signal, reason current mirror will have very high output impedance. This transistor Q3 and Q4, this is having additional functionality of level shifting. This level shifting is required just to ensure that the op-amp output will be symmetrical. It will have symmetrical swing in both the halves. Another importance of transistor pair Q3 and Q4, if we see transistor Q1 and Q2, this is NPN, while transistor Q3 and Q4 are PNP. So emitter base reverse bias voltage, which is the reverse breakdown voltage of NPN transistor, this is approximately 7 volt. While for PNP transistor, it is approximately 50 volt. So suppose this transistor pair Q3 and Q4 is not present. In that case, there is a possibility that if by fault we will connect input to one of the supply, let's say plus VCC or minus VCC, which is normally plus 15 or minus 15 volt. So there will be possibility of reverse bias breakdown. So just to avoid this, this transistor Q3 and Q4, which is connected in series, so effective voltage is now increased. It will be approximately 50 plus 7 volt. So which is much higher than the supply voltage. So any possibility of reverse bias breakdown will not be there. Now coming to the second stage or gain stage. So here if we see transistor Q16 is common collector configuration. Again, it will have high input impedance just to avoid any kind of loading. While transistor Q17, it is working in common emitter mode, which will provide the bulk of gain of 741. By connecting transistor Q17, let's say its input impedance is ZI17. So modified input impedance, if we are looking into the gain stage, that will be approximately beta of transistor Q16 multiplied by ZI17. So because of this multiplicative factor, input impedance will further increase and it will minimize any kind of loading. Now, here because of this combination also, we will have that is common collector and common emitter. This is also called emitter follower stage. So common collector and common emitter configuration, we will have a wider bandwidth. Now here we have used one coupling capacitor. Sorry, this is not called coupling capacitor. This CC capacitor having value of 30 picofarad, दिस हैज बीन यूज्ड फॉर मिलर कंपनसेशन. सो यूजिंग मिलर कंपनसेशन टेक्निक वी विल हैव वेरी हाई बैंडविथ. सो हेयर इट क्रिएट्स ए वन डोमिनेंट पोल. डोमिनेंट पोल अप्रोक्सिमेटली एट 4 हर्ट्ज. वाइल अदर ऑल पोल्स देयर इज ए कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ पोल स्प्लिटिंग इन विच ऑल पोल्स आर शिफ्टेड एट हायर फ्रीक्वेंसी. सो वी विल हैव रोल ऑफ रेट ऑफ 20 dB पर डिकेड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस डोमिनेंट पोल क्रिएटेड बाई कैपेसिटर सीसी. सो वी विल बी एबल टू रियलाइज हायर बैंडविथ एंड वी विल सी वेन वी विल गो टू स्टडी इट्स फ्रीक्वेंसी रिस्पॉन्स. इट्स यूनिटी गेन फ्रीक्वेंसी विल बी अप्रोक्सिमेटली 1 MHz. वन इंटरेस्टिंग पॉइंट एट द सेम टाइम इफ वी सी दिस कैपेसिटर ऑफ वैल्यू 30 pF. दिस 30 pF कैपेसिटर ऑक्युपाइज ऑलमोस्ट 13 times मोर एरिया देन सिंगल BJT ट्रांजिस्टर. सो इफ वी सी दिस स्मॉल वैल्यूड कैपेसिटर हैविंग वैल्यू ऑफ 30 pF, हाउ मच एरिया इट ऑक्युपाइज ऑन द इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द रीजन वाई वी अवॉइड यूज ऑफ कैपेसिटर इन इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट. नाउ कमिंग टू द आउटपुट स्टेज. सो हियर वी हैव यूज्ड क्लास AB आउटपुट स्टेज. बट बिफोर गोइंग टू द डिटेल ऑफ क्लास AB स्टेज, फर्स्ट लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज क्लास A, क्लास B एंड देन क्लास AB. सो दिस सिंपल ट्रांजिस्टर इज क्लास A आउटपुट स्टेज. सो हियर इफ वी आर अप्लाइंग एनी इनपुट, सो वी हैव टू इंश्योर दैट ट्रांजिस्टर Q विल बी इन एक्टिव मोड, मीन्स इन ऑन मोड. सो हियर फॉर इंश्योरिंग दैट दिस ट्रांजिस्टर विल बी ऑन फॉर बोथ द पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव हाफ, वी हैव यूज्ड अ बायस करंट I. सो हियर दिस ट्रांजिस्टर रिमेन्स ऑन इवन इफ नो इनपुट इज अप्लाइड. सो वी विल से द कोसेंट पावर डिसिपेशन इन क्लास A आउटपुट स्टेज विल बी वेरी हाई. सेकेंड, द आउटपुट स्टेज हैव टू प्रोवाइड लो आउटपुट रेजिस्टेंस सो दैट कंप्लीट वोल्टेज कुड बी डिलीवर्ड अक्रॉस द लोड. सो फॉर दिस पर्पज वी विल यूज emitter follower configuration. So if we see this transistor is in common collector mode, so common collector configuration, that is also called emitter follower. So if we will see this voltage, which is nothing but the output voltage V0, this voltage will be approximately equal to base voltage minus base emitter voltage of this transistor. So we will say V0 is equal to VI minus VBE. So we will say roughly V0 is approximately equal to VI. So voltage gain of this common collector configuration is unity. But what is the drawback? Drawback is high quotient power dissipation. And this bias current magnitude must be sufficiently high to ensure that transistor will conduct even in this negative half. So this problem of high quotient power dissipation is removed by using 2 complementary transistors, and these both transistors are working in emitter follower configuration. So here if we again see, for positive half transistor QN will be on, for negative half transistor QP will be on. But what about output? If we see the output, let's say this is plus 0.7 volt, this is minus 0.7 volt. In this particular range there will be no output. Reason: transistor QN will be on if input voltage exceeds plus 0.7. In same way, this PNP transistor will on if input voltage will exceed minus 0.7. 7 वोल्ट. सो हेयर इफ वी सी देयर विल बी ए डिस्टॉर्शन एट दिस पॉइंट विच इज नोन एज क्रॉस ओवर डिस्टॉर्शन. एज फार एज कोसेंट पावर डिसिपेशन इज कंसर्न वी हैव नॉट अप्लाइड एनी बायस करेंट. सो ट्रांजिस्टर्स आर ऑन आर ऑफ डिपेंडिंग ऑन द इनपुट साइकिल. सो हेयर कोसेंट पावर डिसिपेशन इज ऑलमोस्ट जीरो. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द सुपीरियोरिटी ओवर क्लास ए. नाउ इन क्लास बी दिस क्रॉस ओवर डिस्टॉर्शन इज रिमूव्ड. सो हेयर वी हैव अगेन कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री सेट ऑफ ट्रांजिस्टर क्यू एन एंड क्यू पी. बट हेयर वी हैव इंश्योर्ड दैट दिस टोटल बायस वोल्टेज ऑफ वी बी बी इज सफिशियंट टू मेक ट्रांजिस्टर क्यू एन एंड क्यू पी इन ऑन स्टेट इफ इनपुट वोल्टेज रिमेन्स इन लिमिट ऑफ प्लस 0.7 टू माइनस 0.7. सो आउटपुट विल बी समथिंग लाइक दिस एंड देयर विल बी नो क्रॉस ओवर डिस्टॉर्शन. सो इन नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल सी द डिफरेंट स्टेजेस. टूडे वी हैव सीन दिस बायस स्टेजेस. Now in next class we will see DC analysis and AC analysis of 741 IC. Okay, thank you.